Marine and weather experts from the U.S. arrive in the Philippines to lend a hand as the country battles three oil spills. Eight experts from the U.S. Coast Guard and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration will help recover the sunken and grounded ships leaking oil in parts of Luzon. Oil extraction for MTKR Terra Nova has yet to start, with divers still putting metal caps on the pressure valves of the ships. The process is expected to be completed within a week.
Kasi pag nag-siphon tayo, di ba, nagkakaroon ng vibration yun. Eh. Tapos nagkakaroon ng vacuum. Ang iniingatan natin, baka mag-release yung mga valve na yun. Kaya mahalaga yun, tatakpan muna namin. Sisecure muna namin sana, huwag gagalaw. Then after that, safe na tayo mag-siphoning.
Meanwhile, the province of Bataan once again put under a state of calamity, this time due to the effects of the oil spill. The province also suffered from the typhoon-enhanced southwest monsoon last month. Philippine officials moved to finalize criminal complaints against suspended Town Mayor Alice Go, a former presidential spokesman also being investigated for ties to an illegal gaming hub placed on an immigration watch list. Victoria Tulad reports.
Plain harassment. This was how former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque described the immigration lookout bulletin order issued against him by the Department of Justice. He also called it a witch hunt intended to silence him as a critic of the administration. Roque said there is no reason for him to leave the country and assured that he will face his accusers. Roque and 11 others were included in the lookout order in connection with alleged human trafficking in the raided Philippine offshore gaming operator or Pogo Hub in Porac, Pampanga. The DOJ denied the harassment allegation.
I really don't see where that's coming from dahil 12 naman po yung nakalagay dun sa ilbo. And sa tingin naman ho natin, at the heat of it all, no, na dami na pong ahensya nag-investigate ito.
Clavano added that the order is a mere monitoring mechanism.
So, pag lumabas ang isang tao na may ilbo, tinitimbre lang po yan sa immigration. At wala po kaming magawa na hindi palabasin yung tao na yon.
Meanwhile, the preliminary investigation of the DOJ panel of prosecutors on the human trafficking complaint against suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go was deemed submitted for resolution.
Yung iba po, si Mayor Alice Guo and three other Chinese incorporators were not able to file. And it was decided by the panel of prosecutors not to give them anymore another chance or another extension.
The Commission on Elections and Bank, on the other hand, has approved the recommendation of its law department to file an election offense case against Go. COMELEC has determined in its own analysis that Go's fingerprints matched with the fingerprints of Chinese Go Huaping.
Pwedeng mag-issue ang aming law department ng subpoena upang ma-serve sa respondent at kaagad na mapasagot siya doon sa akusasyon laban sa kanya na siya ay nag-commit ng misrepresentation base sa violasyon sa Omnibus Election Code.
For Senator Risa Ontiveros, it is important to investigate the proliferation of unauthorized use of foreigners of government documents, particularly of birth certificates, as these can be used to carry out crimes. The senator said this following the revelation of officials of Santa Cruz, Davao del Sur, that 1,501 irregular birth certificates were issued from their town to foreigners from 2016 to 2023.
The scale of what is also now being investigated in another province of our country will tell us na dapat talaga to get to the roots of our problems with Pogo and with other businesses or political participation na maaaring ginagawa nila undercover of fake Filipino birth certificates or other identification documents.
Ontiveros hopes government will include all related entities in the Pogo ban, including iGaming, in the Cagayan Economic Zone Authority or CEZA.
iGaming sounds very close to IGL. So these could be evolutions lang of one and the same thing. Baka pare-parehong animal lang ang iGaming dati na naging Pogo sa mahabang panahon na recently na rebrand bilang IGL.
CEZA said in a recent House hearing that they do not have Pogos. Meantime, Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation Chairman Alejandro Tenco said he met with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., who responded positively to the idea of sparing special business process outsourcing companies from the POGO ban. These BPOs provide service to gambling firms and are not directly involved in POGO operations, according to Tenco.
Sabi naman niya, o sige, kung ganun naman, ipresenta mo ng mainam sa buong committee na yan at pagkatapos, yung general plan itself na inyong mapapagkasunduan, ipresenta ninyo sa akin.
Because of the POGO ban, the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office will study the possibility of regulating off-cockpit and in-cockpit betting to make up for the lost revenue from gaming operators. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Now let's get an update on the weather from Pag-asa forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Good morning, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina. Good morning to all. So at 3 a.m. today, the low pressure area was estimated based on all available data at 575 kilometers northeast of Itbayat, Batanes. This low pressure area doesn't have a direct effect in our country and is low likely to develop into a tropical cyclone. However, there's a tropical cyclone outside our Philippine area of responsibility and it was located at 2,005 kilometers east-northeast of extreme northern Luzon. This tropical depression doesn't have any effect to our country and moving away from our Philippine area of responsibility. On the other hand, southwest monsoon continues to affect the central, southern Luzon and Visayas. Due to this, expect a cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorm over Zambales, Bataan, Occidental Mindoro, and Palawan. For Metro Manila and the rest of our country, expect a generally fair weather with isolated rain showers and localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. That's the latest in Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel. Two-time Olympic gold medalist Carlos Yulo breaks his silence on controversy surrounding his mother's use of his winnings as an athlete. Yulo says his mother spent without his consent the six-digit incentive he earned from his wins during the 2022 World Gymnastic Championships. He also denies his mother's allegations his girlfriend caused the rift between him and his family. Yulo appealed to put an end to the issue as he says he only wishes the best for his mother.
Napatawad ko na kayo a long time ago. Tigilan na po natin to at i-celebrate na lang po natin yung mga ginawa po ng paghihirap, pagsasakripisyo ng bawat atletang Pilipino dito sa Olympics.
So yun. Tapos nung ano sabi ko,
the lawyer of Yulo's mother insists the issue is being blown out of proportion.
Lahat po ng mga nagko-komento, so long as they are damaging to the reputation of the person, especially if it is based on a fake post, are in themselves separate libels. And everybody who makes a harsh statement based on a fake fact can actually be held liable for cyber libel.
A grand homecoming awaits the country's golden boy, two-time Olympic gold medalist Carlos Yulo, once he returns to Manila. Meanwhile, the former coaches of pole vaulter E.J. Obiena believes he will give the Olympics another shot, this time stronger as ever. Paige Javier has the story.
The city of Manila is gearing up for a hero's parade for two-time Olympic gold medalist Carlos Yulo. Yulo grew up in Malate, Manila, the same place where he started to dream of becoming an elite gymnast. In a Teleradio Servicio interview, Manila Mayor Honey Lacuna said they are coordinating with Yulo's team and Philippine sports officials.
Marapat lang na talagang bigyan natin siya ng bonggang-bonggang parangal sa kanyang pagdating po dito sa Pilipinas at siyempre po sa lungsod ng Maynila.
The parade may start along Liberiza Street near the home where Caloy grew up. Some residents in the area are excited to welcome the Olympian.
Sobra-sobra yung saya namin na dito gaganapin yung parada ho. Caloy, mimiss na namin siya dito sa Liberiza.
Mas maganda nga talagang dito dahil dito siya talaga nagsimula nung pagkabata hanggang sa paglaki.
Another option is for the parade to start at the San Andres Complex. It's located near the Aurora Quezon Elementary School where Yulo graduated in 2012.
It's an honor for us to be visited by the gold medalist, which is an alumnus of our school. Mas matutuwa ang mga bata pag nakita nila ng personal. si Caloy.
The parade is expected to end at the Manila City Hall, where Yulo will be awarded 2 million pesos in cash incentive. The date of the parade is not yet set, as this depends on the return of Team Philippines. In a House budget hearing Tuesday, Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation Chairman Alejandro Tengo said Yulo will also receive 20 million pesos from PAGCOR. Under the law, his coach and trainer will get half of the incentive.
PAGCOR is mandated to give a gold medal, an athlete who wins a gold, 10 million pesos.
So this is a double gold?
So if, since he has two golds, he will, Mr. Yulo will have 20 million pesos. His coach and his trainer will receive a total of 10 million pesos.
The Manila LGU is also looking forward to welcoming pole vaulter EJ Obiena. The city government will give Obiena 500,000 pesos for his fourth place finish in the Paris Olympics.
Kino-congratulate din po namin siya for landing fourth place. Malaki
yes,
kong bagay din po yan. Isa rin pong karangalan para sa lungsod ng Maynila.
Correct.
We are
yes.
Very proud of EJ Obiena. Good.
EJ's former coaches in Chiang Kai-shek College congratulated him for his performance. Despite missing the podium, they say he has achieved so much for Philippine athletics.
Congratulations, EJ. No? Okay naman na yung performance niya kasi so break up the game. Ganun talaga.
We're so proud of you. And alam ko, in spite na hindi tayo nakapag-medal this time, pero I'm sure you'll come back stronger.
Bata pa naman siya. Saka yung si EJ, madisiplina ng player yan. Kaya pag may goal siya, yun yung gusto niyang laging abutin.
The coaches believe EJ's journey to gold does not end in Paris. They say his determination will push him to give the Olympics another shot. The Manila LGU will release more details soon on the Heroes Parade. They believe Yulo and Obiena serve as inspiration to the youth, not just in Manila, but in the whole country. Paige Javier, ABS-CBN News.